Welcome back to another episode of Real Reactions. I'm your host, Isabella, and today we'll be getting some reactions to The Queen's Gambit, starring Anya Taylor-Joy. The story follows Beth Harmon's journey from being an orphan underdog to becoming the greatest chess expert of the 1960s. The series has already impressed the critics and received outstanding ratings. And now, we'll get some real audience reactions to The Queen's Gambit.
Men are gonna come along and want to teach you things. Doesn't make them any smarter. You just let them blow by, and you go on ahead and do just what and how you feel like. Someday you're gonna be all alone, so you need to figure out how to take care of yourself.
Tell the readers of life how it feels and to be a girl
among all those men.
I don't mind it. Chess isn't always competitive. Chess can also be beautiful.
All right, welcome back, everyone. We'll be discussing Queen's Gambit tonight, so let's kick it off. Did you guys enjoy the pilot?
Yeah, I really did enjoy the pilot. I had absolutely no knowledge of what this was about or like anything like that. And then I just looked at a poster and I was like, oh no, like a period piece again. But I ended up being really engaged.
I was genuinely surprised how much this might be like my favorite or one of my favorite things we've watched this year.
I really, really enjoyed it, and I thought it had a super cinematic feel to it, and it reminded me a little bit of something that like David Fincher might do. But yeah, I thought the entire thing had a totally interesting like feel and look to it, and I was most disappointed that Anya Taylor-Joy was not in it really at all, because I think she's, like you guys said, a really great talent, and I'm excited to continue watching to see what she does.
So you guys kind of already answered the next question I was going to ask about if you've seen any of Anya Taylor-Joy's past work. But so going off of that, though, how do we think her past roles are going to relate to this role, or kind of contrast?
She's one of those actresses that's so good at conveying a lot without actually speaking. So in a lot of her best roles, there are characters that don't actually speak all that much. And I think that in the beginning of the episode where we saw her, it was really exemplified.
There was a lot thrown at you in those first 2 minutes. Mm-hmm.
That was actually, I will say that was probably my favorite scene in the opening, in the episode. I thought it was it instantly got me sucked in. I thought it was a really effective opening.
Absolutely. Yeah, I like when TV shows, especially you have to think of it in the context of a pilot, like they're trying to get your attention right away. Just what every pilot should do. So, good pilot. Great performance. In those 2 minutes.
That's a good segue into the next question, which is that we see Beth is highly addicted to these mysterious tranquilizing green pills. How do we feel about drug addiction being a part of her story?
It's like the most heartbreaking part of the episode. Just seeing her get addicted to those drugs through no fault of her own at such a young age. It's like actually genuinely hard to watch.
I think sometimes addiction can follow grief. So I think that was kind of interesting, even though like the addiction wasn't from anything that like she was like consciously doing, because she was like being forced to take the pills essentially. I do think that was interesting to see.
It was portrayed really well. It was like you said, Devin. It was really hard to watch, especially like this girl is just experienced the most like heartbreaking thing of her life. Like she lost her mom, and she finally like finds something that she's good at, And but the caveat is that she needs these pills to stay on her game, which is so messed up. But I think that it's a thing that a lot of people can relate to.
Did we enjoy the overall performance of the cast aside from Beth?
I thought I really enjoyed the janitor's performance. I thought him and Beth had a pretty unique dynamic. I thought it didn't really feel like the stereotypical mentor child dynamic that you see. I thought they did it really naturally, I feel like.
Yeah, I liked the acting in this episode. I didn't feel like the focus of the episode was really on the acting, though. I think it was more on the visuals and even the editing. But yeah, I thought everyone did really solid. The janitor was a standout. I thought he was really great. That child actress too. I mean, I'm always so impressed when such a young actress can give such an incredible performance.
The child actress was so good. Especially I don't know, while watching it, I realized I don't think that the actress smiled once. And it's really sad. It's really sad to see, but she really, really, I don't know. I think it's hard for child actresses when they play someone who's the billboard name of the film or show. It's hard to live up to that performance in a certain sense. And it's always really, really impressive when a child gives such a great performance, especially dealing with, I think this actress has had so much thrown at her in this episode. Also, as Mason said, the janitor was really great.
So aside from Beth, there were a lot of characters that stood out. Who stood out the most to you guys?
Was your name Jolene, I think?
Yeah. I'm pretty sure that's, yeah.
She was a really interesting character. Personally, I really liked that character, and I like the ending scene of the first episode, near the end, where this girl Jolene, you could see, also has that sort of addiction, but she sacrifices her pills because she knows how much Beth needs them. And I guess the janitor too. We're very fond of the janitor here at Real Reactions.
I thought a character that stood out to me, and I'm excited to see kind of more what happens with her, is the woman who runs the orphanage. I feel like she has some bad intentions, and I'm excited to see what she does.
I also really liked Jolene. I'm just really interested in her character. I think it's really nice to have someone who is so familiar with the orphanage, and who all the struggle that the main character is going through, she's very, very familiar to it. I agree that the scene where Beth asked her for more pills, I thought that was one of the best moments in the episode.
Last question though, are we finishing the series?
Hopefully. it is, I'm not making any promises because they are hour long episodes. And I think there's 10 of them, I believe.
I agree with that, especially being in college, and just I try to be very involved in a lot of things, so free time is very spare. But it is a really captivating show, and I do want to see where it goes.
Yeah, I thought it was an excellent pilot, and I'm pretty confident that the quality of that first episode will carry on throughout the rest of them. And I have a little bit of free time this week, so I will be watching more of The Queen's Gambit.
A few fun facts for you. The film is based on the 1983 novel of the same name by Walter Tevis. Another fact, Beth's experience with chess and drug addiction are loosely based on Tevis's own experiences. And before his death, Heath Ledger was going to direct a film adaptation of this story. And lastly, a woman has never won the chess world championship in real life. Yet.
Maybe it's in my blood. My mother went crazy.
Went crazy or always was?
I don't even know if I'm good enough.
You're the best there is.
Accept me for the things that I do.
You've got your gift.
go when it costs.
The Queen's Gambit was about the battle between winning and losing. Well, it seems like the series has won in the eyes of the audience members with a marvelous cast and an intriguing story. Thank you so much for tuning into this week's episode of Real Reactions. Although our reactions may be a little ridiculous and a little bit racy, they're always real.